Need a quick Facebook tutorial for setting up a business page? Well, this is it. And the good news is you can set one up for your business in less than 5 minutes. Let me show you how. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5 Minute Social Media. If you have been struggling with your social media, feeling like you're putting way more out than you're getting in return, you're in a great place. Every week, we release a quick video to help you with a different piece of your social media marketing. If that sounds like something you could use, take a second, hit subscribe, click that bell, and that way you'll be notified every week when we release another helpful video. My name is Jerry Potter, and today we're talking about how to set up a Facebook business page. You've decided your business needs a Facebook. Well, let me tell you this. First of all, not all businesses need a business page, but I will say most of them do. To find out if you're the exception, I put a video together for that. You can find it right here or in the description of this video. By the time we're done today, you'll know how to set up a Facebook business page, and I'll tell you how you can get it verified as well. By the way, Facebook business pages, fan pages, like pages, they're all the same kind of page. Facebook just calls them business pages now. So to get started, make sure you have your company logo or something for your profile picture, something for your cover photo, a big photo to go on top, and then all your pertinent information. What is your website, email if you have that, phone, address, business hours, any information about your business, which I assume you already know. Gather that and you can do this in just a few minutes. All right, let's get started.
Now, there are a few different ways you can get to the create a page, but I think the easiest thing is just be at facebook.com. I'm logged into my account here. And you do, by the way, have to have a personal profile to create a business page. So that is a first step if you don't even have a Facebook account. But once you've got that, you'll see right here at the top, it says create. Click on that. All these different options. I'm going to say create page. And that gets us here. Now, if for some reason you don't see that on your page, I'll include the direct link to this in the description of this video. Next up, you're going to choose, are you a business or brand or a community or public figure? This is pared way down. They used to have way more options than this. So for this tutorial, I'm going to set up a page for a fictional consulting company. So I'm just going to choose business or brand. Then I need to name the page. What did I call it? Oh yeah, it was based on a logo template I found in Canva. Vague Whale Consulting. Next, you're going to choose a category to describe your page. And in this situation, you just start typing something and find something that works for you. So consulting agency, there I go. I'm going to choose that. Then hit continue. Next, it'll ask you to add a profile picture. Yes, you can skip this, but hopefully you already have it ready. When you're adding your profile picture, if you are a one-person business or you represent the business, I think it should be your face. If the company has a logo, make it the company logo. Don't make it anything else. Remember, most people are going to see it most of the time in a tiny circle on a mobile device, so it should be something easily recognizable. So I have this logo standing by. Next up, upload a cover photo. This goes at the top of your business page. This is a photo that should represent your business. If you have a physical location, it might be a picture of your facility. If you have a staff, it could be a picture of your staff. Later in this video, I'll point you in the direction more about what to do when you're trying to decide what goes in your cover photo. But I'll go ahead and upload the one that I chose for Vague Whale Consulting. Once your cover photo is uploaded, you can drag it to reposition it, figure out the best spot for it to be. And just like that, you have a page. That's it. But you're definitely going to want to do more than that. For example, you're going to want to go in and fill out all of your company information. So you see right here, it says add a short description. We consult businesses on how to grow, but we never give them specific advice, just really vague suggestions. I'm sure this company will do very well. Hit save and continue. If you've got a phone number, put that in. If not, uncheck that. This company is fake, doesn't have a website, but I'll put it in anyway. Next, it says, now that you've updated your page info, see if there are other details you can add that will be helpful to people who visit your page. Let's go ahead and click Edit Page Info. This is where you can go through and fill out all of your information. You can add additional categories. So if I type in consulting again, let's say I am a business consultant. So I can add that in and hit save. If you decided you do have a phone number, email address, location, all these different details about your company, your business hours. Fill out as much of this as possible because eventually, if somebody's looking for a business on Facebook, the more information you have, the higher the chances that somebody is going to find you. All right, last step, you're going to want to give your page a username. This is where your web address will be on Facebook. So it'll be facebook.com/whatever your username is. So click right here underneath your profile picture and title, and then type in what you would like it to be. Lucky for me, Vague Whale Consulting is available. So I go ahead and hit create username. So now if I look up at the top here in the address bar, you can see it's facebook.com/vaguewhaleconsulting.
So there you go. You have a Facebook business page. Two more things you should do. One is get it verified. If you are a local business company or organization, it's super easy. And I've got a link on how to do that down in the description of this video. And secondly, I've put together a 5-minute Facebook facelift. So whether you've had your page for 60 seconds or for 5 years, this is some things to look for in a 5-minute video on how to optimize it for profit. You can grab that link in the description of this video as well. Got any questions on something I didn't cover? Let me know down in the comments. I read every single one of them. I can help you out there. And if you like this video, give it a second to give it a like. Hit subscribe. Thank you so much for watching 5-Minute Social Media. You're not only supporting me, but also my two tiny superheroes at home.